Namaskar. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. And if you are new to my channel, hi, this is Pooja and I make videos on topics related to physics and science. So today let me introduce you to various figures and terms that you will be finding quite useful if you want to know the functioning or working of any nuclear radiation detector. In this video, we'll be talking about the pulse mode, the pulse height spectra, the counting curves and plateaus, energy resolution, detection efficiency and dead time of radiation detectors. Let us start with the video. So let us talk about the modes of detector operation. So there are three general modes of radiation detectors. What are these? These are the pulse mode, current mode and the mean square voltage mode. So what happens is that out of all the three modes, it is the pulse mode that is most easily applied, while the current mode also finds uses in many cases. Let us talk about the pulse mode of operation of detectors, which is the normal mode of detection of most of the nuclear radiation detectors. Detector zyada baar ho gaya. So next important thing is that in all the detectors where you want to find like energy of the incident radiation, there the pulse mode has to be applied. So in the pulse mode, the time integral of each current pulse is recorded and you find out the total charge Q that is deposited in the detector. And since this charge is directly related to the energy E, therefore while operating any detector in the pulse mode, you can calculate the energy of the individual radiation quanta. Now, the nature of signal pulse produced from a single event, it depends upon the input characteristics of the circuit to which the detector is connected. So, as you can see, this is the equivalent circuit. Here, R represents the input resistance of the circuit and C represents the equivalent capacitance of both the detector itself and the measuring circuit. For example, if a preamplifier is attached to the detector, then R is its input resistance and C is the summed capacitance of the detector, the cable used to connect the detector to the preamplifier and the input capacitance of the preamplifier itself. Jo VT hai, that is the time dependent voltage across the load resistance, and it is this fundamental signal voltage on which the pulse mode of operation is based. So time constant kya hota? Time constant is the product of the resistance and the capacitance. Tau is equal to R into C. So two cases will arise. First of all, when this time constant is less than the collection time, and other one is where this time constant is greater than the collection time. So as you can see, in case of small time constant, kya hota hai? So here the time constant of the external circuit is kept small compared with the charge collection time, so that the current flowing through the load resistance is essentially equal to the instantaneous value of the current flowing in the detector. So the signal voltage produced under these conditions has a shape nearly identical to the time dependence of the current produced within the detector, which is illustrated. So the radiation detectors are sometimes operated under these conditions where high event rates or timing information is more important than accurate energy information. So next we talk about the cases where this time constant is much, much larger than the charge collection time. It is generally more common to operate the detectors in the opposite extreme. So in this case, very little current will flow in the load resistance during the charge collection time and the detector current is momentarily integrated on the capacitance. If we assume that the time between the pulses is sufficiently large, the capacitance will then discharge through the resistance, returning the voltage across the load resistance to zero, and the corresponding signal voltage VT is illustrated as shown here. So we draw some general conclusions, and what are these? First one is the time required for the signal pulse to reach its maximum value is determined by the charge collection time within the detector itself, and no properties of the external or load circuit influence the rise time of the pulses. On the other hand, the decay times of the pulses or the time required to restore the signal voltage to zero is determined only by the time constant of the load circuit. So the important conclusion that we draw from here is that the leading edge is detector dependent and the trailing edge jo hai aapki, that will be circuit dependent. Another important thing is that the amplitude of a signal pulse shown as Vmax in this figure is determined simply by the ratio of the total charge Q created within the detector during one radiation interaction divided by the capacitance C of the equivalent load circuit. Because this capacitance is normally fixed, the amplitude of the signal pulse is directly proportional to the corresponding charge generated within the detector, and it is given by the simple expression. So we conclude that the output of a detector operated in pulse mode normally consists of a sequence of individual signal pulses, each representing the results of the interaction of a single quantum of radiation within the detector. The proportionality between Vmax and Q holds only if the capacitance C remains constant. In most detectors, the inherent capacitance is set by its size and shape, and the assumption of constancy is fully warranted. In other types, the capacitance may change with variations in normal operating parameters. In such cases, voltage pulses of different amplitudes may result from events with the same Q. In order to preserve the basic information carried by the magnitude of Q, a simple type of preamplifier circuit known as a charge-sensitive configuration has come into widespread use. So this type of circuit uses feedback to largely eliminate the dependence of the circuit amplitude on the value of C and restores proportionality to the charge Q even in the cases in which C may change. So now that we have talked a lot about the pulse mode of operation, let us look at a few of the advantages that this mode of operation has to offer. First is that the sensitivity that is achievable is often many factors greater than when using current or MSV mode, because each individual quantum of radiation can be detected as a distinct pulse. The second and more important advantage is that each pulse amplitude carries some information that is often a useful or even necessary part of a particular application. So in current and MSV mode, this information on individual pulse amplitudes is completely lost, and all interactions regardless of their amplitude, they contribute to the average measured current. Because of these inherent advantages of pulse mode, the emphasis in nuclear instrumentation is largely in pulse circuits and pulse processing techniques. So I hope you liked this video and it wasn't that boring. Do keep on watching and do not forget to subscribe to my channel, and please hit the like button. Do support us and do let us know how you feel about the video. Till then, this is Pooja saying goodbye, and take really good care of yourselves.